As COVID cases surge, schools across the country are scrambling to respond. America's largest school district, New York City, is on the brink of stopping in-person learning. Right now, 2.6% of coronavirus tests in the city are positive. The mayor says if that number hits 3%, he will close public schools immediately. Meg Oliver shows us how schools across the nation are struggling to keep kids and teachers safe.
There is no justification not to try.
Katie Dempsey, a high school math teacher in the Chicago area, says she's desperate for in-person learning to resume.
Is it far less scary once you're actually back at work and teaching in person? Absolutely.
Dempsey, who is back in class 5 days a week, has two kids, both with severe communication disorders. Her older son, Ryan, is back in school full-time.
Do you like being on Zoom, Joey?
While her younger daughter, Joey, is struggling in an all-remote learning situation.
She cries that she hates Zoom. She wants to go back to school.
We're terrified. We're terrified.
It's a different story for Crystal Atlas, a second grade teacher in Broward County, Florida. She has two small children and an immunocompromised relative at home. Atlas returned to in-person teaching yesterday, scared for her family's safety.
I didn't sleep. I didn't eat. There were a lot of tears, a lot of panic.
COVID cases in children were up 17% earlier this month, and America's biggest school districts are split on reopening. There's in-person learning now in Houston, with plans to switch to hybrid learning in Las Vegas. In-person teaching is now put off until at least January in Los Angeles, but there's no target date in Chicago. Dr. Brahim Ardolik is the executive director of Staten Island University Hospital.
Is it safe for teachers to go back?
If you do it properly, you can safely have people in school. But the reality is, once you have certain populations where the incidence of positive disease goes really high, there is that concern of general spread because the likelihood of more and more people having it is there.
In New Jersey, the most densely populated state in the country, the positivity rate sits above 12%. Schools in some municipalities, like here in Montclair, are all remote because of those numbers. But Governor Phil Murphy says he will not issue a statewide school shutdown. Tony?
Meg, thank you very much.